Hey everybody, welcome back to our weekly live stream for our Mighty Steps virtual walk. I'm Bob McMahon, your MC for the Utah Down Syndrome Foundation Mighty Steps virtual walk. This is week number 12. Wait, this just in. We are rewinding back to week number 11, where due to technical difficulties, we were unable to show the interview with the DeBoer family and their video. But this is a new week, so let's go back to Weber and Morgan counties and meet the DeBoer family. We shall start with the interview with the DeBoer family. Here we go. It'll play this week. I got you on that one. All right, let's go. Thank you so much for being with me, DeBoer family from Morgan County. Can you please introduce yourselves to us?
We're the DeBoer family, and that's Klaus. We have Brighton, KJ, Cole, and we have Olivia, like Janelle.
All right, such a beautiful family. Now, how long have you all lived in Morgan County? What are some things that you like to do there? And what are some of the awesome places that our viewers should visit if they're in Morgan County?
So we've been in Morgan County for almost 3 years now. We love it up here. We really enjoy spending most of our time outdoors, whether it be boating at Pineview or skiing at Snow Basin Resort, or camping up at East Canyon. Why don't you tell people places we should go?
I like to go to the bowling alley down by the splash pad.
Ooh, the bowling alley by the splash pad. Oh, someone else likes the splash pad. Awesome. What are some other awesome things in Morgan County that people can do?
There's also Taggart's Grill that's really delicious.
And then you should really get a shake afterwards.
At Jay's.
Oh, so fun. And you can't miss the peacocks that are there at Taggart's either. So that's some awesome stuff. Now, we have this special question about Olivia. Hey, Olivia, what do you like to do? If you could tell us, what would she say?
What does she like to do, guys?
She likes to read books and play our chickens and bunnies and any outdoor animals.
Mm-hmm. She loves to read books and play with bunnies, chickens, and other outdoor animals. That's awesome. For you guys, what would be some advice that you'd give new parents of a child with Down syndrome?
So in our limited 2 years of experience, I would just tell new parents that to just enjoy the ride, enjoy every moment, because it just keeps getting better.
I would also say, like, reach out to families that have kiddos with Down syndrome so you can network and or reach out to UDSF or other organizations or anything that you know to, so you can kind of know what to expect or what's going on and just hear different people's perspectives.
I agree. Thank you so much for that advice of reaching out and making connections with others in the Down syndrome community. Thank you so much, DeBoer family, for sitting down with me here, letting our viewers get to know y'all. Thank you again, and you guys have an awesome one.
Thank you.
It worked. I knew it would. All right. And since we were having those technical difficulties last week, seeing the video that the DeBoer family made for us, let's take a look again at that video that they made for us. Let me pull it up here and share my screen again. Here we go. We're gonna get it this time. This week is the week. All right, and play. There we go. It worked, and it was awesome, and it was so awesome that they shared with us other members of the Down Syndrome community there in Weber and Morgan counties. And that shirt that said Up Syndrome, totally awesome. All right. Excellent. So let's fast forward again to the present and start off week 12. So we have a slideshow here for you that I am to share. So let me share my screen yet again. Here we go. All right. Now, George S. Patton once said, accept the challenge so that you can feel the exhilaration of victory. Congratulations to all of our Mighty Walkers for taking on the challenge to walk across Utah with their loved ones with Down syndrome. We hope that you have found hope, health, and happiness along the way. A reminder, you have 2 days, which is this Sunday, August 23rd, so today and tomorrow, I guess, to get all of your steps entered into Walker Tracker if you want them counted. Now, let's take a look at what we have accomplished. If it'll click on slide 2. There we go. We have together our 33 teams have take in 41,860,544 steps, which equals 7 times of walking across North America. We have collectively burned 1,883,724 calories. We lost 538 pounds, so don't we look so good as a foundation. We raised $30,000 and we helped 36 individuals with Down syndrome walk across walk across Utah. Excuse me. Great job, everybody. Are you ready to feel the exhilaration of victory at the Mighty Steps virtual victory lap on next Saturday, August 29th at 10 a.m. right here on this live stream? I know I am. So here is what we need from you for the victory lap. We need, if it'll click on it. All right, we need for everyone to send in team photos with walking bibs to info@udsf.org. So we need a picture of your team walking with your bibs by Monday, August 24th. You can email to info@udsf.org. All right. So all those photos will go into a compilation video. Okay. So slide 4, here we are. Another thing that we would like from everyone is for you to send in your Mighty Steps Shuffle video to info@udsf.org by August 27th at 5 p.m. Now, if you are confused on what I'm talking about, let me show you what you missed, because last week was quite the entertainment value. So here we go. The Mighty Step Shuffle tutorial. I can share my screen.
Hey, everybody. Let's all do the Utah share. Down Syndrome Mighty Steps for Down Syndrome Shuffle. Are you ready? Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. To the right. To the left. Walk around Utah. Walk around Utah. Mighty steps. Mighty steps. Everybody's doing the Mighty Step Shuffle. Again, to the right. To the left. Walk around Utah. Walk around Utah. Mighty steps. Mighty steps. Everybody's doing the Mighty Step Shuffle. To the right. To the left. Walk around Utah. Walk around Utah. To my steps. Woo. Mighty steps. Everybody's doing the Mighty Step Shuffle. One more time. To the right. To the left. Walk around Utah. Walk around Utah. Mighty steps. Here we go. Mighty steps. Everybody's doing the Mighty Step Shuffle. Thanks so much, everyone, for joining on the Mighty Step Shuffle. Let's do it.
Wasn't that just fantastic? I think I recognized the guy in there. Man, what a guy to wear a tutu, a pink tutu, pink shirt, pink shoes. And did you see those cuties dancing with him? Oh my gosh. I've got to say, that was fantastic. So that is the tutorial for how to do the Mighty Steps Shuffle. All right. So here's what we need from you. We need you to go and find that copy of the tutorial, which can be found in last Monday's email, as well as this coming Monday. You'll receive an email with the tutorial yet again. You can also find it at udsf.org. Look for Mighty Steps. Then Mighty Shuffle. All right. Email your video. Again, here it goes. Email your video to info@udsf.org by Thursday, August 27th by 5 p.m. The State Walk Committee will select the top four videos, which will then be shown on the live stream. The live stream audience will vote for the winner. So invite all of your friends and family to join our live stream next week and vote for yours. The winner receives a $50 Amazon gift card. Woo! All right. So, awesome stuff. Mighty Step Shuffle. And next, we are having, to kick off the virtual victory lap, we are hosting our traditional auction. But this year, it is online. The auction opens on Monday, August 24th at 8 a.m. and closes Thursday, August 27th at 5 p.m. An email and text with the auction link will be coming this weekend. Also, the UDSF website will be updated with details. Some of the auction items include a $100 Seago Lily Spa gift card, a delicious two-layer 8-inch round cake from Front Door Cakes, as like you can see right there, and a one-hour foot zone. What's a foot zone? Well, check out the Mighty Auction to find out. All right. So, also, what should we expect? Once this thing clicks here. All right. What should we expect at the virtual victory lap? All right. So, we should expect some hope, health, and happiness. We have a live interview with John from John's Crazy Socks. So he will be on the interview from New York City. You can vote for Mighty Step Shuffle videos. As for health, Heather Blair from Catalyst Behavior is going to be with us to speak about self-care and mental health during COVID. And as for happiness, we have that Mighty Step Shuffle dance contest. And we have an award ceremony. All right. Check your email, your coming Monday email, for more information. So, how's about we get to our destinations this week? We have some fantastic destinations. But first, I have to say a huge shout out to a sponsor, Members First Credit Union. All right. So, this week, our destination stop is Box Elder and Cache Counties. Viewers, make sure to comment and question. One of our most dedicated Mighty sponsors is located in Box Elder County, Members First Credit Union. Here to talk about Members First Credit Union and about his family is Darren Hodgson and the Hodgson family. Here we go. Hello. Thank you so much, and welcome, Hodgson family. First question for you. This one's for you, Darren. How long has Members First Credit Union been a sponsor, and how did they get involved with UDSF?
Well, since Becca was born, they've been involved with Mighty Steps and the Down Syndrome family. But we've been involved in the community. My boss has been involved in the community forever. And only 2 years ago did I ask him, I said, hey, maybe it's a conflict of interest, but how would you feel about volunteering to support Mighty Steps? And he said, jump into it. If you want to do it, the credit union will support you, will support the community. Since I'm over the accounting department, I took a little bit of money from the budget, from the marketing department, said, I'm taking this. We threw it at it. We got the Box Elder cheerleaders, the Box Elder High School student government. They all jumped in, and last year we had more fun at the Mighty Steps event than we've had in a long time. And so that's how we got involved. And I just want to thank my boss for letting me take time off of work to be able to go do this stuff. It's been awesome.
That's great. I mean, I was up at the I was up at the walk in Cache County and seeing everyone in those shirts that you're wearing. That was a big crew. It really was. Next question for you. Now, what would you want our community to know about Members First Credit Union, and what are some of the services that they offer?
You know, our biggest deal is our community. We love the community, and that's what we want to do. This community has supported us forever, and so we like to give back and just support the community. We jump into the schools, we help out with the schools. Obviously, you can do all of your finances at the credit union, anything that you can. We just point you in directions where might suit your needs, but we are part of the community. Our vision is the community. We love the community.
Community and family. So, I mean, if we're talking about the community and families, can you please introduce us to your family?
Well, we've got the one in charge, which is my wife, Mandy, or Becca might be in charge. We have Dirty Harry Harrison. I've got a lot of kids that aren't here. They're playing volleyball. I've got one that teaches us K through 5 special needs class down in Utah County. And then the one who got us involved in all of this is Reckon Beckham. Say hi, Reckon.
Hi, Beckham. That's fantastic. Such a beautiful family. So question for you, how long have you lived in Box Elder County? What are some of your favorite things to do there as a family? And where should our viewers visit when up in Box Elder County?
We were born and raised in Box Elder County.
I lived here for 40 years. We moved when he had a job in Salt Lake. We lived in Davis County for maybe a year or two, but other than that, we've lived here our whole lives.
All right.
Born and raised here, never did grow up, but one of the things, we live so close to Maddox, we just like to go eat at Maddox.
Hadn't mentioned Maddox, I was going to. So yes. I'm glad you mentioned it.
My kid works there.
Two of our sons work there.
And so I always tell them, hey, bring me something home to eat. and everything else in the community, we love to go. He's in charge, so if there's water involved in it, that's what we do. Mm-hmm. Manaway Reservoir, Willard Bay, the splash pad, Brigham City Pool is absolutely incredible. And it's shallow enough, he's a fish. And so it's the only way that you can sort of keep track of him. And
Box Elder County is very community oriented. We've spent most of our lives having kids and being involved in just, you know, peach days and the community, you know, football games, homecoming week, just it's such a tight knit community that, I mean, we go to volleyball games, softball games, this community is just really tight. So we spend most of our time in the community participating in sporting events or local events. They have a farmer's market every Saturday and it's a beautiful, our main street, just they'll open up all their shops and you can just walk down and then local vendors will come out and so you can do that. And there's lots of food trucks that come and now there's a lot more food coming into Brigham City. So that's good.
That's awesome. I mean, there's a lot of fantastic things to do in Box Elder County. So last question for you guys before we look at some of the highlights of Box Elder County that you've made for us is actually before that, I almost skipped one of the most important questions. This question's about Beckham, Mr. Reckon Beckham. Aside from Reckon, what does Beckham like to do?
What do you like to do?
Eat ice cream.
Eat ice cream. All right. What else?
What else?
What's your favorite thing to do?
Mommy eats sushi.
Oh. Mommy eats sushi.
What do you like to do?
Daddy eats.
you like to go? Where do you like to go?
Go home.
Grandma's home.
Hey, he likes grandma's home. He likes his mom and dad. Sounds like he likes family. Yeah, I mean, we already shared that he likes swimming. This is awesome stuff.
What's rule number one? What is it?
Party.
Rule number one, never grow up. Beckham, he seems like such an awesome kid. Now, having such a Reckham of a Beckham, what advice would you give new parents of a child with Down syndrome?
I would say, obviously, what other families have said is get involved in the community. You're not in the world of Down syndrome until you're in the world of Down syndrome. And I had people reach out to me. I luckily had my neighbor is actually the founder of the Down Syndrome Foundation. She lived right from Utah, right in my backyard. So I had some connections and just getting me involved in. So Beckham was born about 3 weeks before the first buddy walk that we ever went to, and to go there and meet so many families, and they helped me. They gave me directions, told me about the Up to Three program, the Christmas parties, and we started to plan play dates where we could talk, and I learned new things, and they understood, and I understood, and that was the biggest thing. So I would say get involved and just help the next person. When someone reached out to me, I said, give me a number. Give me someone that I can reach out to. And I had lots of people. Our next door neighbor had someone they worked with, asked me to call, and now we're great friends. I mean, I didn't know them before that. So just pass it on. Whatever you get, give it on. So
I'd say do not expect any less from your child with Down syndrome than the other children, because if you expect less, you'll get less. So we expect the same thing out of Reckham that we do the other kids.
I have to say those couple pieces of advice are so very pertinent and true. I wholeheartedly agree. So how about we take a look at the video that you guys put together for us. So viewers, remember, you still have a little bit of time to comment and everything as this video is going. We will go into the twilight zone for a quick second as we pull up the video. Here we go.
Be sure, dry your eyes, 'cause better days are sure to come. When you smile, be sure to smile wide, and don't let them know that they have won. When you walk, walk with pride, don't show the hurt inside, because the pain will soon be gone. When you dream, dream big, as big as the ocean. When you...
Oh no! YouTube went awry! Classic YouTube. But while YouTube thinks about coming back and everything, and while it buffers some more, this is one fantastic video so far, I have to say. Brings so much joy. All right, how about we keep on watching Reckham Beckham getting his thing on in Box Elder County. Here we go. Hopefully our buffering has caught up.
When you dream it might come true. When you dream it. And when you laugh, be sure to laugh out loud, cause it will carry all your cares away. And when you see the beauty all around and in yourself, and it will help you feel okay. And when you pray and pray for strength to help you carry on when the troubles come your way. And when you dream, dream big, as big as the ocean blue. Cause when you dream, it might come true. When you dream, dream big. Dream big. And when you laugh, be sure to laugh out loud, cause it will carry all your cares away. And when you see the peace all around and in yourself, and it will help you feel okay. And when you pray for strength, it will help you carry on when the troubles come your way. And when you dream, dream big, as big as the ocean.
All right. Excellent stuff. That was fantastic. Twilight Zone again. So while we still have you, let's look at some of the comments that we have coming in on our live stream. From before, we had Darren Sorensen said, "Go ladies and Jen." This needs to be on repeat regularly. I believe Darren was talking about the Mighty Step Shuffle. Darren also said, Darren's saying a lot of stuff. Now, I do have to say, Darren is watching this from Austria. All right, that is in Europe. So you're getting some comments from Austria, Hodgson family here. We have love the pictures of our Morgan County heroes and Weber County heroes. Cameron Flanagan from the Flanagan said, "Funny today." Katie McMahon, my wife, said, "So now I'm craving Maddox." Thanks, guys. Now we're gonna have to like take a trip up there and get some steak. Darren Sorensen said, "Great combination of ice cream and water." Cameron Flanagan said, why do you like food?" All right, that might be for mom of why you like sushi. Might be towards that comment.
We do this little thing where we tell him his hands, what does mommy like, what does daddy like, just to help him with his memory. And he knows that mommy likes sushi. So that's, I think, what he was trying to say.
Awesome stuff. Excellent. And Kyle Sorensen, coming from Minnesota, said, "We love Box Elder County." And Kyle Sorensen also said, "Dream big, everyone." Thank you to grabbing the Ryan Shoup song for us. That was an awesome choice. And also Darren Sorensen just wrote in, "Beckham, can you come mow lawn? Can you come mow our lawn? Well, when we move back to Utah."
Will you go cut his lawn when he comes back to Utah? Okay.
All right. There we go. So those are all of our comments and everything coming in for the Hodgson family. So I just have to say, Thank you guys so much again for being with us today, Hodgson family.
Thank you for doing it.
All right. Thank you guys. We'll see you later.
See ya.
I reckon.
There's a cool dog.
All right. Excellent stuff. All right. See you guys. That was amazing. So, our last but definitely not least stop is Cache County. Woo! We made it across Utah. And also, our final sponsor is Gossner Foods. You can find Gossner Foods at gossner.com. I forgot to mention that you can find Members First Credit Union at www.memfirstcu.com. All right. So going back to Gossner's, Gossner Foods at gossner.com. Each and every morning, our local Utah and Idaho farmers are up before the sun and bring us the freshest high mountain milk in the world. This dedication to consistent quality is what makes Gossner Foods a premium choice. The quality is not just in the milk, but in the people themselves, staying true to generations old principles of hard work, integrity, and honesty guides each and every drop of milk and every ounce of cheese. When you are a part of Gossner Foods in any facet, you become part of our family. All right, so there we go from Gossner Foods. And we're bringing in the Hawkins family from Cache County. Welcome, Hawkins family. Hello.
Hi, Randy.
Thank you so much for being with us.
Wow.
Oh, that's so cute. Oh my gosh. It's too much for me. It's so cute. Guys, Hawkins family, you're the last ones from Utah that we have, and you're representing Cache County. So can you please introduce us to your family?
Sure. We are, like you said, the Hawkins family. I'm Kevin. This is Stephanie. She is, she's in charge. Just like we have Sydney. Sydney just turned 5. She started kindergarten this week, and she loves it there. And then our youngest daughter, Wright, she will turn on Halloween.
All right. Sweet stuff. And now, I know that you guys live in Logan, the center of Cache County. So how long have you lived in Logan? What are some of your favorite things to do in Cache Valley? And where will our viewers visit the next time they are in Cache County?
So we have been here for almost 3 years. Came here from Texas and Pennsylvania and Idaho before that. Favorite things to do here. So we spend a lot of time outdoors. You'll see that in our video here later. A lot of hiking as a family. I like to ride motorcycles and mountain bikes. We do some fishing. What else? Utah State University is here, and so that brings a lot of different events and things to do. They've got a creamery up there with some really good ice cream. Aggie cream is definitely something. If you've never been to the area, that's a pretty common, you got to stop and get some Aggie ice cream. But Gossner is really good too, so you probably better have both just to be safe when you come through the area. What else, Steph?
There's the Lazy One outlet. There's
shopping.
There's the Creamies outlet. I feel like there's more. There.
Pepperidge Farm.
Mm-hmm.
You can go and buy deformed goldfish for really, really cheap.
Yep.
It's pretty awesome.
Yeah, there's lots to do here, I feel like.
That is so very true. And if any of our viewers were wondering, we're just having a little lag issues. It's okay. Don't worry. Our sound will catch up with with each other. But if we do look like some of the old dubbed movies, it's all right. Don't you worry. It's not on your end. It's on ours. There are so many fantastic things to do in Cache County. Yeah. Okay. Here we are. It's on this side of me. I am repping the Utah State University. I also lived up in Logan with my family for 10 years. So love it up there. Super important question for you. How has UDSF positively impacted your family?
Sorry, everyone's like scattering. So for us, Rep was a birth diagnosis. So we didn't know she had Down syndrome until after she was born. And that's kind of a scary to hear because just a bunch of unknown things. Yeah. For us, it was at least. And so we reached out to the Cache County chapter of UDSF. And Maria Leishman is the girl that's like in charge, like the head of it, I guess, is what you call her. And she was amazing. I think she came before Riley was even like a week old to meet me and her and just kind of talked to us about Down syndrome and it's not that scary of a thing. And she showed me pictures of her own child that has Down syndrome and all the fun things they still do. And she helped me so much to just because I started Googling when I first had her, which I recommend no one do. And helped me to kind of like bring it back to like reality and what was real. And it was amazing. And then we went the first act Christmas. It was a Christmas party because she was born on Halloween. So our next one was Christmas. And that was amazing. We fell immediately into this little group that was like a family. We felt like part of them and they were so welcoming and it helped us so much. We have probably the best doctors in our county, I would say. And they're just amazing people and we're so grateful for them, especially when we first had her, but even continued now.
It was really good for me too. Like Stephanie said, with, you know, not knowing what to expect and all of a sudden, you know, everything was totally in at the hospital. We kind of learned that, you know, the nurses and the doctor right away could tell, oh, mate, this, you know, this baby might have Down syndrome. We didn't see that at all. We just, we were kind of oblivious, really tired parents and everything had gone well. And I had come home and was cleaning the house and putting some blinds up or something and finally answered my phone and kind of got the news that, hey, they're going to test her and, you know, check out her chromosomes and stuff. And it was just this whirlwind of emotions, but having the, you know, UDSF and having that kind of support structure and being able to go to the events and seeing people with, you know, children that have Down syndrome of all different ages that are there. There's teenagers and toddlers and just kind of seeing, getting to see all of that and, you know, seeing the different stages and being able to talk through it just was really, really helpful for us. And for Riley.
Yeah, I was also introduced to the Utah Down Syndrome Foundation through Maria Leishman there when we had a birth diagnosis at Logan Hospital. So, yeah, it is a great group up there. Now, I do know that you guys also made a video. So, how about we go into the Twilight Zone? We watch that video on YouTube. Hopefully it buffers well this time. So let us take a look at our video from the Hawkins family. And here we go. Thank you. And wasn't that so cute? many props to the Hawkins family here. That was by far my favorite song that anyone has done for their videos. But then again, I am biased because I love EDM music. So how about we take a look at our comments for the Hawkins family? Here we go. We have... All right. Cameron Flanagan, hi. Are you like this shirt? Are you know about that? I wonder if Cameron is talking about either the shirts that the Hodgson family is wearing or the Utah State University shirt. Either way, they were both awesome shirts. Thank you, Cameron. Jamie Boyd gave a heart. Kyle Sorensen said, my heart just melted. What cute little girls. Oh, that's to you guys, Hawkins family. And Kyle Sorensen also said, you are lucky to have so many great places in Cache County. So true. Katie McMahon, my wife, says, I say yes to double the ice cream. She is a big fan of Aggie ice cream, as is all the rest of my family. Kyle Sorensen, Minnesota. Oh, she's so cute. Kyle Sorensen said, it's so great to have a network of support to put your mind at ease. And Jamie Boyd also went and said, we love sweet little Riley with another heart. And Darren Sorensen from Austria in Europe said that Parley Sorensen, which is one of his children, asks, what is your favorite flavor of Aggie ice cream?
I don't even know what it's called, but the blue one. It's like the Aggie blue.
I'm talking about because there are multiple blue ones. You've got Aggie Blue Mint, and then some other one that is a lesser blue 2-1.
Not the mint one. I think it was some kind of berry. Maybe it's blueberry. I don't know. I know blue's not a flavor.
Okay. Well, our marketing out in the world begged to differ. one of the blue ones. All right. But not Aggie Blue Mint. All right. Good to know. And Jamie Boyd also said she has this sweet, sweetest little smile. And Cameron Flanagan from the Flanagan says that it is nice to meet you guys. So there are our comments for the Hawkins family. And to wrap it up, I have to say thank you so much, Hawkins family, for being with us here today and helping us bring our Mighty Steps for Hope, and Happiness walk to a conclusion at the finish line in Cache County. So thank you so very much, Hawkins family.
Thanks for having us.
Lucas is
back. Can you say bye?
Bye-bye.
Now she'll be quiet.
You blow kisses?
It's all right.
There it is.
All right. Thanks so much, guys. Kisses. Bye bye, Hawkins family. Oh, she's just too cute. Now, to move on to the winners of this week's walking and fundraising challenges. Walking challenge week 12 was. The challenge this week is to reach the finish line by Friday, August 21st at 5 p.m. That was yesterday at 5 p.m. All teams who have walked across the entire state of Utah will be entered into a drawing to win a pizza party for their teammate with Down syndrome. The pizza party includes a $20 gift card for pizza and a dance party kit. For those teams who also made it across the entire state of Hawaii, your team will be entered into a drawing for the second time. So here's the teams that got into our walking challenge jar. we had our little constellation, Outstanding Olivia, Team Easton, Oliver's Odyssey, Lucky Luke's team, Haley's Golfers, Taylor's Thunder, Corbin's Goonies, Marie's Mob of Mentors, Best Burrito Patrol, Bennett's Masters of Disguise, Hip Hip Hooray for Molly, and Team Flaniclan. Also, the teams who walked across Utah and Hawaii were entered twice, like I said before, into the drawing. So those people who were entered twice were Outstanding Olivia, Oliver's Odyssey, and Corbin's Goonies. So let me show you my eyeballs. Here's my eyeballs. Here's my mixing. I can't even see what I'm mixing, but I can feel it. And our walking winner is Team Easton. All right. So congratulations to Team Easton. That was winning a pizza party because, you know, Easton, our, what is he now, four-month-old? Easton, our four-month-old, definitely needs a pizza party, including the $20 gift card for pizza and a dance party kit. We're going to start him young on some pizza. So congratulations, Team Easton. Also, our fundraising challenge, the team who raises the most funds between Monday, August 17th, and Friday, August 21st, by 5 p.m., will win a waterproof speaker, and the money they raise will be matched up to $500 by a new friend of UDSF. So the winner is Beth's Burrito Patrol, who raised a whopping $512.82 this week. That brings their total fundraising monies to $2,967.79. Add the matched $500 means that Best Burrito Patrol, and I don't know why someone put just Best Burritos, but we all know that it's Best Burrito Patrol, all right? We're not shortchanging you, Beth Bagley. All right, so adding the matched $500 means that Best Burrito Patrol has raised $3,467.79 during our 12-week walk. Way to beat us, Best Burrito Patrol. You took first place from Haley's Golfers. I see you. All right. But congratulations. All right. That's some awesome stuff. So congratulations to all of our participants and especially our loved ones with Down syndrome for walking across Utah this summer for hope, health, and happiness. Don't forget to email us your photos of your team walking with your bibs. Remember, that is going to info@udsf.org. And get your mighty shuffle on this week and send in those videos also to info@udsf.org. I can't wait to see if any of your videos can beat my shuffle in a tutu. Mm-hmm. All right. Challenge thrown. All right. Let's check our comments before we go. And it looks like we don't have any more comments from people. So let's wrap it up here with our final reminders. Don't forget to send pictures of your team wearing bibs and your Mighty Steps or your Mighty Steps shuffle videos to info@udsf.org. All teammates are invited to send pictures and videos. So those in Austria, those in Minnesota, California, Ohio, whatever other states we have and countries, all right, every team member of every single team should be sending in those Mighty Shuffle videos, all right? And you can also use the hashtag, I believe it's the hashtag Mighty Shuffle if you're putting it on social media. All right. But you can send it to info@udsf.org. This Monday, August 24th, is an important day to remember for two big reasons. The Mighty Steps online auction opens at 8 a.m. and Monday is also the deadline for all recycled rides nominations. So I do want to share my screen one more time. Let's go into the Twilight Zone one more time. And I want to show you where you can find that. So if you go to udsf.org, here is the website when you go to udsf.org. So you just scroll down, you find events and news, and the one that says Geico and UDSF. Click on that one, and here is our recycled rides program. So you will find the information you need about recycled rides right here. We are looking for nominations. So right here it says, if you or someone you know are in need of transportation, please fill out the nomination form below and email it back to UDSF by August 24th. So that's this coming Monday at info@udsf.org. UDSF will forward your nomination form to Geico, who will then send it to their selection committee. All right, so there you are. And woo! If you haven't heard of the amazing opportunity, please follow where I just went. All right. UDSF was in partnership with Geico Insurance and National Auto Body Council, and thereby giving away two pre-owned and repaired cars to families or individuals who have been hit hard by COVID-19 and are in need of transportation to provide for themselves or their family. So if you know someone who lives in Utah, and is in need of a car, please fill out the nomination form and email it to info@udsf.org by Monday. One last, I do see people are trying to throw those comments in at the last second. So let's go. Katie McMahon said, way to go, Beth. You are amazing. Lane Bagley from Best Burrito Patrol said, shout out to Bob for all your hard work and amazing Saturday morning entertainment. Thank you, Lane, for beating out my Haley's Golfers and winning the grand fundraising prize. And Cameron Flanagan from the Flanagan said that everyone's kids have been so cute. So I totally agree. As always, please go to udsf.org for more information. Our virtual victory lap is next Saturday at 10 a.m. And as always, I am Bob. Thanks so much for watching, everyone. I will see you next Saturday, August 29th at 10 a.m. at the Mighty Steps virtual victory lap. Don't forget to check out our online auction this week. I triple dog dare you to outbid me on the auction items. All right. Thanks so much, everyone. And we will see you next week at the virtual.